Gavin, and this is
Ian.
We're here for our Passion Time project about how does the NBA draft work, and we have 25 questions, 25 facts about it.
This is the first fact. We got the draft starts at around 7:30 Eastern Time.
Our second one is the commissioner runs the NBA draft every year.
And the thing that had to go with the first fact is that it's in Eastern, so like it's not the same in the time we are in because it's in Easter time. And the NBA draft started in the 1947s because that was when the NBA was kind of created.
The fourth question fact was there are only two rounds in the NBA draft, but gives undrafted players the chance to try out for any team.
So, like, Gavin, explain that more. Like,
That means, like, if you don't get picked, you can try out for the team, and then next year you can have a chance of getting on the team.
Yeah, probably a more bigger chance because you tried out last year and you have dedication to the game. International players who are under 23 are automatically eligible for selection, while the players younger than 22 have to declare their eligibility. Like Lonzo Ball, he was under, so he had to get declared under, declared to be like over 23 and be able to play in, which he did get drafted, which is very good for him, but like that's pretty hard to do, like very rare to be able to do that, like getting picked straight out of like your first year in college.
And our sixth question is there are only two rounds in the NBA draft. Both rounds have 30 picks, so that there are 60 picks in the whole draft. So they rounded the rounds down to two like every 20 or 25
yeah,
years.
So thing is, the rounds got lower and lower until they got into two rounds. And that means there's 30 picks, which each team gets two picks, and there's 60 picks in the draft. So that means there's 30 teams, and each team gets two picks. Our seventh fact is each team gets one pick a round and two picks in the whole draft, which we kind of explained that in our last fact. If they get 20, there's 60 rounds and each player gets, there's 30 picks and each team gets two picks in the draft. And our
eighth question of fact is you need to be 19 and older to be in the draft and go through 1 year of college, but you used to be able to start in high school.
So that's kind of like what I was explaining about Lonzo Ball. He went through 1 year of college and then he got picked. So, he went through his first year of college playing for UCLA, and then he went to the NBA draft, and he got picked, which is a very lucky thing. But even crazier, went late when there was, like, a bunch of rounds, and, like, each team had around 20 picks or something. It took, like, a really long time to finish the draft. There would be kids coming straight out of high school without even a year of college trying to make it into the NBA, which I don't know, maybe someone had done that, but that is that's harder than making it out of the first year of college. That's just really crazy. So our ninth fact is there used to be 10 rounds, but until 1985, they shortened the rounds to 7 rounds, which it kept getting smaller after that. Then by 1989, the National Basketball Player Association, the draft onward had been limited to 2 rounds with 30 picks, 1 pick per year. So there used to be 10 picks, which that was in 1985, then it shortened to 7 picks in 1989, and then as like it hit to the 2000s, it shortened to 2 rounds and 30 picks, and a very good player, Isaiah Thomas. He was picked very late. I think it was in, he was picked very late, and he was, no one believed in him for being a very good player, but he turned out to be one, an all-star player who's one of the best in the league.
Our 10th fact is the teams do a coin flip in a lottery to find out who gets the first pick, and usually the worst team has a better chance of winning the lottery.
So that means that
they get a better chance of getting the first round pick in the draft. So that means they get to choose what player they want first.
And if you're wondering what the lottery is, it's like one of those lottery machines, the thing where you have the ball and you scroll it, and then the ball comes out, or a piece of paper, and it says which one, who has it, and let's say it's tied up, they might do a coin flip to see who wins it, because if it was tied, I guess, then they wouldn't be able to decide, and sometimes they do a coin flip to see who gets the most balls in the lottery thing. Our 11th fact is there used to be not that many foreign players, but when the years went by, the foreign players massively increased. Like, it, every year, like, they just kept coming in. There was barely any black players in the NBA. And there was no foreign players. But as years passed on, more and more foreign players. And around 1,000 foreign players play in the NBA, I think. I think that's correct. That around 1,000 play in the NBA. And it used to be that none played around 1989.
My 12th fact is if you didn't get picked, you can try out for a team and maybe you can be on that team next draft.
So that was what we kind of explained about if you didn't make the draft, you can try out for another team. Gavin, didn't you explain that?
Yeah. So it's like one of our facts that it's if you don't get picked in one of the two rounds, you can try out for the team that you want to be on, and then if they like that you, if you play good, play any position, you can be drafted the next year.
Yeah, like if you're gonna try out and you're a good player and you didn't get drafted, next year could be your chance to be drafted. And if you didn't get drafted that year, you could try out another year and then another year. And then until you think, hey, I don't think I'll ever be drafted. And then our 13th fact is the NBA draft lottery is an annual event held by the NBA where the teams did not make the playoffs in the past year. So this fact kind of is complicated to explain, but if all the teams that made the playoffs, they have a least chance of making or winning the lottery. The teams that didn't make the playoff have a better chance of getting a first round draft pick because they didn't make the playoffs and they weren't that good of a team. So they average a higher chance at winning and they get a couple more balls than the other players who didn't make the or who made the draft. So that's the NBA lottery. They named it lottery after the name of the lottery because in the lottery you move around the thing and then the ball comes out and then you get your lucky numbers and see if you win.
Our 14th fact is the NBA draft is hosted only in the month of June. So that means every year the NBA draft is held only in June. No other month.
Yeah. And that's a true because last year I watched the draft, it was in June, or the 2016 draft. When you watched it, did you see that it was in June?
No, I didn't watch the NBA draft.
Oh, okay. The 14 teams that don't qualify for after the playoffs are entered in the lottery to determine the draft order for the first 14 picks. So yeah, we explained that. If you didn't make the NBA, if you didn't make the NBA playoffs, then you get those 12 teams that didn't make it, because 14 teams that didn't make it. All the other 16 teams that made it, they have a less chance of making it, that getting the first draft pick, than the 14 teams that didn't make it.
Our 16th question is, all the teams that didn't make the playoffs get four balls, combination of three lottery.
In the lottery. So, Gavin, could you try explaining that?
After when the draft starts or the lottery, you get a piece of paper with four ball combinations. The combination means like 2,576. That means if you get that number, that means that you have the first round pick. Or if you tied with someone, you gotta do a coin flip and see who gets first pick. It goes on until the third team, till the three teams that the three teams to get the first, second, and third.
And it also explains that all the teams that didn't make the playoffs, they get four balls more than the teams that did make the playoffs. And our 17th fact is the NBA draft and the NBA lottery are done in the same place, because some people think that the lottery is taken in a different place than the draft, but I'm pretty sure that the draft is taken. It is taken in the. It's taken in the same place as the lottery. I think they do it before the draft, or maybe a day before the draft, so they determine who gets the first pick at all those things.
The NBA started having two rounds in 1989, so that's when they shortened down the rounds to two.
Okay, yeah, because remember up here, they had, there used to be 10 rounds, but until 1985, then it shortened to 7 rounds in 1985, and then by 1989, the National Basketball Association took it to 2 rounds. But there used to be 10 rounds. Do you know how long that would take? Like, that would take so long to finish a draft. That would be around, like, maybe 3 hours long, 2 hours long, just to do a draft. That would be crazy. That's like times 5, the 2-round draft. There used to be a coach who could pick players and play on his own team. He was 25 years old. So yeah, this was a very, like, crazy thing that happened back in the olden time. I don't think you can do this now. But this coach, he drafted his players, but then he's practically drafted himself, because he would play on the team with him. So he would be a coach, and he would also play, which is very cool, like, to think about. A coach that actually played in the NBA, a coach / player. I mean, that would be, like, the best job ever.
Our 21st fact is, in the NBA, girls have tried out to make the NBA, and two girls made it onto a team, but when it came to 2 rounds, most of them stopped trying.
So that kind
that
of
means, like, two girls made it onto the team, but then after they shortened it to 2 rounds, the girls just made their WNBAs. That means Women's National Basketball Association.
Yeah, because, like, when there was 7 to 10 rounds, there wouldn't be that many good players. And there were a lot of, back then, good girl players that played. So they would try out, but with 2 rounds, a girl getting into the NBA, they would have to be one of the best NBA girls. And even though
even those girls that made it to the NBA,